Pooja, that is a constant work in progress, right? Like, I think the fact is that there is an image of us that we want to live. And then we find ourselves, even with our feminism and our enlightened ideas falling short of that image, we find ourselves more socialized than we ever thought we would be. We find ourselves living the lives of cliches.
Well, I mean, I think, Barkha, I found myself living a life of cliche at the age of 40 when I decided to really terminate my marriage, because I was married for 10 years and I woke up achingly lonely, and I realized then that I needed to rewrite my narrative. I dropped the bottle. I gave up alcohol. And, you know, one of the reasons that I speak so openly about it, because I think that even addiction and recovering from it somehow is a male mainstay. And men have the privilege of drinking openly and even recovering openly. And for women, it's stigma and it's shameful. So I turned the world into my AA class and I dropped the bottle. And what dropping the bottle gave me was something marvelous. It made me realize that there's no difference between a toxic relationship and a glass that you drown yourself in. And then that is when I started living. And 4 years down the line from then, I think I rewrote my narrative from being something that I'd grown up to believing was true for me, at least, that and they lived happily ever after, converted finally to and she lived happily ever after. And everything came to me naturally after that. I mean, Bombay Begums, I don't think I would have been able to really accept and throw myself into with so much of truthfulness and vulnerability and openness and without any preconceived notions about, in fact, fear about, would I be able to deliver on this great part that I've been offered and live up to the trust that has been bestowed upon me by my director, by Endemol, by Netflix. And I wouldn't have been able to be in that place if I had not somewhere freed myself of those influences that I had weighed myself down with as a woman. And yes, it's terrifying to start life all over again at 40. It's terrifying to kind of constantly rewrite your narrative. But it's only when I've been willing to start from scratch, like that spider who goes up that spout, gets washed out, and dares to start all over again, has the universe bestowed so much of grace on me. And I think Bombay Begums is a manifestation of exactly that. It's far more than, you know, a show. It's far more than a comeback. It's the experience of being able to be with these fine women, these fine men, and feel wanted, feel loved, used as a cathartic experience to be able to kind of touch something in you that you know is still alive, that still responds to instruction, you know, and where you can look at yourself and say, hey, I'm going on the set today as a newcomer and I know that I don't know. And not resting on your past laurels, because it's too easy to say that, you know, when I was 19, everybody over a certain age, I mean, like today I can say, oh, everybody over 40 at some point has had my poster on their wall. So what? There's a whole audience who does not even know who the hell I am. Besides being Ali Bhatt's sister.
Is that, has that been tough to be known as Ali Bhatt's sister?
No. That's the age. I mean, like, it was a sister.
I get it.
A lady came up to me one day with a young daughter and said, hey, please, you have to remember that, you know, this was our Alia Bhatt. And I think that was the sweetest way she got to describe it to her kid, because everybody from the age of 3 to, you know, 26 is bonkers about Alia. And my constituency is slightly older in that sense. So it,
But I do not know, and I don't know, I'm sure all the women on this panel agree. I actually do not know another person who could sit there and so matter-of-factly talk about her battle with alcoholism, about ending her marriage, about the loneliness that she felt. I think we all agree, Pooja, that that is you.
And still continue to feel. I mean, you know, I mean, look at the last year, Barkha. What have we all gone through with the pandemic? I mean, come on, we've all been to hell and back in our heads. The fact that we're sitting here and talking to each other and we still manage to keep our wits about us, all the people out there, I think we need to salute ourselves, because, I mean, this world should have come together with far more kindness, but somehow we still find time to hate. So I think that if you've gone through the night, if you haven't kind of, you know, ended it for yourself and you kind of are still out there, applaud yourself more. So I think that, you know, for me, I realize I have one life. I've realized that you can't please everybody no matter what you do. And my only commitment to myself is to be true to myself And some people will get it, some people won't, but that's life. You can't please.
But before I go to the others, how lonely does that get? Because in some ways, this question is the heart of Bombay Begums, right? That you live on your own terms, but that's going to leave you with moments of deep loneliness. You're going to find yourself not fitting into the boxes that society placed you in. You're going to step out of your relationship sometimes to seek happiness. You're going to sometimes accept compromises in relationships. Your relationships may not even be what gives you the biggest thrills in your life. I think all of that is played out in the different characters of this series. So for you, in real life, how lonely was that moment at 40 when you decided to end your marriage, kick the bottle, but then talk about that? Talk about all of it.
It was lonelier to be in a marriage where there was zero communication. It was lonelier to be in a situation where society expects you and gives you a tick saying, okay, she has made it work for 10 years. And then they forget about you. I mean, it's only news to the world when you get married, when you get divorced, when you're born, when you die. In between, nobody is there to wipe your tears. And I did not want to blame somebody else for my unhappiness. And I decided to walk my talk and start life all over again. Yes, you stumble. You wonder how it's going to be at 70. If you make it till then, you won't have someone to kind of hold your hand and walk down the hospital corridor with you. But that is a choice I make. Am I open to love? Of course I am. I mean, I have deep relationships with a lot of my friends, including the women who are on the screen. And I have more time to be able to love them all. I'm bothered with some silly person having messaged me or not messaged me. So I've always said, Alankrit, I said, the line that Rani actually tells Shai in Bombay Begums, where she says, risk your life for your art, not for some silly boy. That's the 49-year-old Pooja talking to the 19-year-old Pooja.